Welcome to the High Museum of Art. We're partnering with Wish here in Atlanta to bring together an evening that really talks about the power and importance of design. So it's really with great pleasure that I invite him up to the stage. Please welcome Jeff Staple.
I'd like to hold the mic.
Hello, everyone.
Hey.
Actually, this is the first time I've ever been to Atlanta in my life. We've been working with Wish for a minute now, and they've been a great partner for us. Atlanta has just always been like such a cultural hub in the world, for music, for fashion, for retail, for design, for food. You know, like, it's just a cultural hub. So it's definitely a place that I've always wanted to come and experience firsthand. The greats have all displayed here, and like great artists of history have been on exhibition here. And the fact that now I get to speak on what I've learned in my, you know, 18, 20 years of design is really, really a blessing. I mean, I have to pinch myself sometimes and think like how, you know, from when I started this industry, where it didn't even have a title, it had no name, you know, there was no category for it, to now it's like a full-fledged, you know, thriving culture, and then to be accepted on like a museum level platform like this to be spoken about, it's mind blowing to me, you know, so it's really an honor and a blessing to be here.
I'm gonna tell you what people told me. It's impossible. You, not possible to have your own company and to have your own business. So I looked up what this word meant. Unable to be, unable to exist or happen. So then I did something interesting. I looked up impossible under the website urbandictionary.com. And Urban Dictionary says, some of the greatest achievements were made by people too stupid to know that they were impossible.
I actually love to teach. If I always say, like, if I stopped doing Staple one day, I'd just be a full-time teacher. I'd be like the happiest person ever. So doing these things where I do talks and lectures, and I'm working with that company called Skillshare.com, it sort of empowers me as the instructor to do it the way I want to do it, you know? So it's really key that I try to tell them what I learned. It took me 10 years to figure out these mistakes that I've made. Why should I make the next kid go through 10 years of mistakes too? Why can't I tell him, like, yo, do it this way and shave off 9 years of his mistake making so that he's gonna make other mistakes, but he's gonna learn that much better, you know?